get a nice little cable, like USB cable, micro USB. And you get an auxiliary line input. So all you do is you push the button and you get this into pairing mode. And as we bring in the phone here. Hey guys, welcome to another video. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at a really cool gadget from Inateck. This is the BR1001 Bluetooth receiver. Let me get the glare out of there and you can see it a little better. But this is going to allow you to hook this up to any non-Bluetooth device and allow it to actually be a Bluetooth receiver. So let's go ahead and open it up and take a look. There's not a lot to look at on the packaging, so let's open this up. Looks like we'll get out the unboxing knife and get this opened. Got some tape here. And this is a really nice solution for those non-Bluetooth devices that you actually want to enable with Bluetooth. And so let's get the package out. And as you can see, very small, compact design is exactly what you would want in this. Let's go ahead and get the device out. There we go. Okay, so you get quite a few little things in this little box. So you've got the user's manual, which not too much to go over, but a little bit. You get a nice little cable, a USB cable, micro USB. And you get an auxiliary line input. So, got that. This is actually what you'll use to plug in to your device, like your receiver or whatever, to actually enable it Bluetooth. So, the actual device itself, you've got the micro USB, you've got your line in right here. Then you've got some buttons here, looks like a volume up and down, and that is all there is to this device. So I'm going to go ahead and get this set up to a device that does not have Bluetooth, and we're going to do a demonstration as to how this works. And this is really cool, so stay tuned, we'll be right back. Hey guys, welcome back. And what we've done is we've come out here to the vehicle and we're going to do a quick demonstration of this Inateck BR1001 Bluetooth receiver. This is just one of the use cases that you can have for this, and this is actually a really good one. So what we've done here is we've come out to the vehicle. This has a full charge, so it's running on its own battery power now since we've charged it up. And I've taken the included 3.5 millimeter jack or cable that's for auxiliary, and I've plugged it in, and you should have, a lot of most of the newer vehicles anyway, have an auxiliary jack somewhere. You may have it on your stereo or you may have it somewhere else, but I have mine down here. So I've plugged this in, and as you can see, it's just running into the Bluetooth receiver. I did the pairing. So all you do is you push the button and you get this into pairing mode. And as we bring in the phone here and let this get into focus, you'll see here, if I can find it on here, there it says Inateck's BR1001 is connected. So I am paired with the Inateck Bluetooth receiver. So all I've actually done now is come up to my stereo system and I've put it on auxiliary. And it's pretty simple, I just hit the auxiliary button here. So now it's looking for input through the auxiliary jack. So now what I'm going to do is actually come to my phone and we're just going to bring up the music player and we're just going to hit play. And you can see the music is actually coming through my car stereo system Bluetooth wise, so I can listen to anything on my phone that goes through the Bluetooth through my car speakers. And this doesn't have to be tethered or anything or cabled up, it's just Bluetooth through it. This comes in really handy. A lot of use cases, if you want to listen to audiobooks through the Bluetooth of your phone, if you got audiobooks like Audible stuff, you can project that through your car stereo system. Podcasts, I actually do have some podcasts. I will give some props out here to some of the podcasts that I subscribe to. So there's some of those. So if I actually wanted to go into this one and actually hit play, I'm going to listen to this podcast.
Tech show number 517.
And shout out to Mike for Mike Tech Show. If you haven't, if you're into tech and you haven't checked out his show, check it out. It's really a good podcast. So anyway, you know, you can listen to podcasts, music, whatever you want through this. And again, this is just one use case to make anything that's got an auxiliary jack, and you don't have to have the 3.5, you can get an adapter if you want and plug this into an auxiliary jack and make it a Bluetooth device. You know, my vehicle does have Bluetooth, but not to play stuff through the phone. It's only got Bluetooth so I can connect and do wireless calling. And they do have, you know, they used to call them iPod kits and stuff like that that you could get installed on your vehicle. Those are kind of going by the wayside, and they're going more towards the auxiliary. So this is, like I said, just a quick example and demo. This works really, really well. Have no problems with it. I don't know what kind of battery life I'm going to get out of it. I might come back and post an update on that, but you know, based on what it says, I might be able to get like 3 or 4 hours battery life out of this. But heck, it's so small. You know, I had it hooked up to one of those little mini Lester chargers that was like 3,000 milliamps. You could just keep this plugged into that, and that would be giving it its juice. So this battery would just keep charging, and you would be good to go. So, you know, you're not even really going to be limited to battery life if you just want to keep a charger on this and let it go. And hell, you could even plug this in micro USB to your car charger. Like, I've got a port right down here that's USB. I could just plug this in and power the USB receiver just like that. Just plug this in, and that would keep it charging. So a lot of options. So you're not going to be limited to battery life if you've got some creativity and some other devices and gadgets up your sleeve that you can just keep this baby powered. If you have a long trip and you just want to listen to some tunes or some books or some podcasts, you're good to go. So anyway, guys, check the show notes for a link for this. It's very affordable, and it's very practical and very useful. So again, this is the Inateck BR1001 Bluetooth receiver. I highly recommend it. It's a good device, and it's not all that expensive. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up and a subscription to the channel. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. Have a good one.